Did you know that the Khalsa Heritage Center has been crowned as the India's number one museum in terms of visitors' footfall, popularly known as the Eighth Wonder in local parlance? The museum topped the popularity charts in the museum world in the year 2019 and also got registered in the annual reference books such as the Limca Book of Records, the World Book of Records, India Book of Records, and the Asia Book of Records, and many other awards. The Limca Book of Records also mentioned it to be the India's top-ranked museum in terms of visitors' footfall. So now let's look at some of the mind-boggling stats about this museum. So the museum gets 5,000 visitors every single day and 7,000 visitors on a weekend, and it also set a world record of 20,000 visitors on a single day in the year 2019. Some reports also suggest that the museum has a total of 97 lakh visitors till date, and the outstanding fact is that it was able to achieve this within a span of just 7 years from its inauguration. And due to the influx of large number of people, apart from making it a top-ranked museum in terms of visitors' footfall, it has also proved as a boon for the town of Anandpur Sahib in terms of boosting its economy. So now, what was so special about its architecture that it was able to attract so many visitors on a daily basis? And the museum which we are talking about is none other than the Khalsa Heritage Center, which is now known as the Virasate Khalsa Museum. And the task of designing this beautiful museum was awarded to the Israeli-Canadian architect Moshe Sabdi, along with Ashok Dhawan as the associate architect, and the amazing interior display was done by the very famous Amardeep Behl. The Khalsa Heritage Center is a museum of Sikh people and is located in the holy town of Anandpur near Chandigarh in the state of Punjab. So the museum celebrates 500 years of Sikh history and the 300th anniversary of Khalsa, and is totally based on the scriptures written by the 10th and last Guru, Guru Gobind Singh. So the site allocated for the museum measured 75 acres in total area with the hills as its backdrop. And it is one of the world's largest museum dedicated to depicting the journey and the history of one single community. Architect Moshe Sabdi began the design of this museum in the year 1997, and finally it got inaugurated in the year 2011. So it took approximately 14 years to complete this beautiful museum. So in today's case study, we would be focusing on various factors such as the design challenges, the spatial planning of the museum, the structural arrangement, the materials used, and the lessons that we need to take back from this museum that has become world famous. So now, before proceeding further into looking at the planning of this museum, let's first understand the brief that was given by the Chief Minister of Punjab, Sri Prakash Singh Badal, to architect Moshe Sabdi in their very first meeting, saying that "We Sikhs have suffered a lot in the past and we are planning to tell a story through this museum." So the primary aim of this museum was to instill a sense of pride in the minds of the people, which could strike a psychological nerve in their minds. And the second part lied in the functional requirements, which consisted of art galleries, permanent exhibition spaces, a library, a 400-seater auditorium, a cafeteria, an open-air amphitheater, and a visitor's center, etc. All that comes under a museum brief. So before starting on the actual design process, architect Moshe Sabdi visited the historic towns of Rajasthan and Punjab, where he could draw inspirations from and incorporate it into the museum. He got inspired by the rich heritage of Anandpur Sahib and its elements like the hills and natural valleys, streams, and also from the historic Golden Temple. The use of water body around the structure, a distinct element in the life of the Sikh community, and the gold-plated dome of the Golden Temple see its inspirations in the museum in the form of central reflecting pool and stainless steel plates for the roof. So these were some of the ideas which he derived after seeing the fortress architecture and various other places. The form is assumed to rise from the sand cliffs as if it was grown from the site itself. And it also tries to mimic the hills behind in some or the other way, lending the building a great sculptural effect. The board building form, which we will see in the planning, is also inspired from the subliminal act of hands offering prayers in Sikh culture. So all these ideas stand true to what architect Moshe Sabdi also believes in, which states that a building cannot be experienced as independent of the land in which it is rooted in. And now coming to the planning of this museum complex. The whole heritage center is a complex which is divided into three parts, that is the eastern complex and the western complex, which is connected by a 540 feet bridge, and the central part, which consists of a large water body. So when looking at the zoning broadly, the eastern and the western block consists of the closed section, and the central part consists of the recreational facilities like the cafeteria and the open air amphitheater. The entry to the museum is from the eastern as well as the western block, but the main entrance for the tourists lies in the western block. Now coming to the micro planning of each of these complexes, the western complex forms the gateway for the town, so it houses functions which respond directly to the needs of the people, which consists of a ticketing counter and the exhibition galleries, a two-level library centered around a grand reading room which overlooks the water garden, some facility for storing archival materials and the meeting rooms, and lastly a 400-seater auditorium for hosting various functions. And the central complex consists of public facilities such as the cafeteria located at the base of the bridge overlooking the vistas towards the large water body. A series of reflecting pools through the arcaded walkways creates a 7-acre water body which is again inspired from the Golden Temple of Amritsar. The central complex also has an amphitheater which is used to perform various activities during festive occasions. And the western complex provides a pedestrian access towards the eastern block, which consists of the permanent exhibition gallery presenting the Sikh history, its religion and culture. So the eastern block has three major buildings, that is the boat building, the flower building and the crescent towers. As the board building form is inspired from the subliminal act of hand offering prayers, it consists of the largest hand painted mural in the world depicting the past and present of Punjab as seen in its villages, towns and cities. The moment you enter the first phase, there is a darkness in the room and then suddenly echoes voices of chirping birds and a blue tint of light becomes visible. You watch the murals standing on a walkway giving you a 360 degree view of the surrounding murals on the walls with multiple color panels to create a three-dimensional effect. The feeling and the view is hard to put in words and must be experienced. In the flower block, galleries are arranged in a group of five that reference to the five virtues of the Sikh religion, which are the truth, compassion, love, humility and contentment. Each petal houses a gallery tracing the life history of all the gurus such as Guru Nanak Dev, Guru Amar Das, Guru Angad Dev, Guru Ram Das, and the growth of the Sikhism from birth to attaining salvation. Therefore, each petal describes history about that specific guru. The third block is a crescent-shaped building which covers the lives of Guru Har Gobind, Guru Har Rai, Guru Har Krishnan, Guru Tej Bahadur and Guru Gobind Singh.
सच्चे गुरां दे नाम ते ओदे प्यार दे पैगाम ते
So all the moments from the history were mapped out and presented on the walls of the gallery, thereby taking the viewer in an immersive experience into its history. And now these simple steps taken into consideration during the planning of this museum have given rise to some of the great features that need to be highlighted, which have contributed greatly in making this journey amazing. So the first feature that needs to be highlighted is the great use of lights. In spite of not using natural light in this museum as compared to many other museums, here a conscious effort was made in keeping the entire room dark and only highlighting the exhibit part with different color LED lights, which keeps the viewer engaged in the history. And the most significant feature of this museum is the vibrant use of colors displayed on the 14 meter high walls in the interiors and the homogeneous nature of colors in the exteriors. As color is a main part of the Sikh community life, it becomes an enriching experience to see it unfold in the form of exhibits in a museum. When the museum integrates with the landscape to display a beautiful contrast of color aesthetics. Generally, traveling in museums from different galleries can bring about museum fatigue because the user does not seem to connect with the artifacts. But in this case, just by changing the display typology and most importantly, introducing the sound element which is in sync with the artifacts makes it an unimaginable experience. So there is a multi-sensory engagement that is visual plus audio. And the fourth and most important feature, that is the change in the display typology. Usually in most of the museums, artifacts are displayed separately with a glass case, but in this case, The inside facade itself acts as the display, and there is no need of keeping separate artifacts. In this way, this museum has completely changed the way artifacts were looked upon in museums. So there is an attempt made to reduce the relatability factor between the viewer and the artifact. And the local people have handmade some display pieces that have created the sense of belonging amongst the Sikh community, giving rise to a participatory approach. Breaking free from the monotonous ceiling height galleries and artifacts after artifacts, here the changing volumes of galleries and also the display pieces either from the ceiling or the walls makes it an unforgettable experience and keeps the viewer engaged in the museum journey. The strong use of geometric forms lends it a sculptural look from the outside and also demonstrates the strength and power of the Sikh community. Now coming to the structural arrangement of the museum complex. The use of RCC shear walls in the construction of this museum have made it comparatively simpler, eliminating any structural complexity. The structure is entirely made with RCC shear wall construction, cladded with Gwalior sandstone from the outside and virendal trusses used to span the floors. The homogeneous use of material has created an unique identity in its setting. The massive geometric forms are dressed in RCC with Gwalior sandstone from outside, with upwardly curving roofs of the museum's tower-like galleries covered in stainless steel, designed with reference to the rich tradition of the gold domes that crown sacred Sikh buildings such as the Golden Temple in Amritsar, with glass used for skylights and the interior exhibits in ACP panel sheets. So the material palette was definitely inspired from the traditional architecture such as the Golden Temple and the fortress architecture, but in a complete contemporary way. So now, what are the lessons that we need to learn from this iconic case study and incorporate it into our design process? So the first lesson that we need to learn from this case study is that the way this museum injected a sense of pride in the lives of people, either by involving them in the artifact making process or telling stories through an experiential journey which everyone can relate to. And the second most important lesson that we need to learn from this case study is the power of storytelling in architecture. Usually, museums are designed for one specific event or a specific personality. But this is the first of its kind of a museum which depicts the history of one single community. So this museum has truly taught us lessons of the power of storytelling through experiential architecture and how we can represent the city events in one single museum. And thirdly, moving away from the showcase typology to the experiential one, it has completely changed the way museums were looked upon earlier merely as the container of artifacts and due to which people got bored. But here, the journey of struggle, sacrifice, courage and excellence since the birth of Sikhism of about 500 years ago is weaved out beautifully through the audiovisual experience plus the spatial experience that is given to the viewer observing the space. The form of the museum complex demonstrates the strong strength and unity of the Sikh community all throughout its festive activities. And the museum acts as a magnet for attracting people and thereby boosting its overall economy. So the frequency of people visiting the museum has increased to a large extent, thereby setting new records. So we can see the strong influence of Louis Kahn in this building, as this building is said to be the return of architect Moshe Sabdi to India, as he had worked in the 1960s with architect Louis Kahn on the Indian Institute of Management. So the Khalsa Heritage Museum is more sculptural than Kahn's brick buildings, but the geometrical roots are still evident in the design. It is a design that attempts to bridge old and new, the traditional and the contemporary. Like Kahn, Sabdi uses cylinders, cubes, arches to create architecture on a grand scale. So now many of you may have doubts as to whether architecture can really touch people's life. So let me tell you, this museum is a prime example of the same, and you can really experience this by visiting this museum. So the museum is monumental in form but emotional in its design approach, and therefore we can conclude this by saying that it is a museum of the people, by the people and for the people. So that's all from my side for today, guys. If you think you learned something valuable from this case study, please do not forget to hit the like and subscribe button below, and do let me know in the comment section what are the top 3 takeaways from this case study which you would like to incorporate it into your design.